Big news coming in on the NEET hearing that's currently underway in the Supreme Court. Petitioners, as per reports, have said NEET UG test not a fair examination. Petitioners say reiterating a retest demand. In fact, a whole bunch of petitioners have asked for a re-examination of NEET as they claim that paper has been leaked extensively across 5 different states and the integrity has been compromised, as also observed by the Supreme Court. Now, the petitioner is saying that NTA is not cooperating in Bihar probe. Let me cut across to Srishti Oja for more on that. Srishti, we hear that the petitioners have, of course, dug in their heels on a re-examination, citing NEET paper leak across 5 different states. And while that said, there's also talk about NTA not cooperating in the Bihar paper leak probe. Would you be able to detail for us what currently is the status of the hearing that's underway on NEET?
Well, yes, Naveela, the court has been hearing a batch of pleas which have alleged irregularities in the NEET UG examination. Since the beginning, the petitioners have maintained before the court that a retest is is crucial and is required in this particular situation because it's almost impossible to segregate the untainted ones from the tainted ones. It's very difficult to segregate who cheated and who did not. And also, according to them, the magnitude of the paper leak that happened, the effect was not just a localized effect, but a pan-India effect, considering 23 lakh students are involved in this case. According to the petitioners, a retest should be conducted. The court has since the beginning maintained that whether or not a retest is to be directed will depend on how, on the magnitude or the on the magnitude of the effect of the paper leak which took place. On the last occasion, we heard the top court very clearly say that the fact that a paper leak had happened in Patna and Hazaribagh, the fact that the question papers were disseminated before the exam was conducted on May 5th is very clear. There's no doubt about that. What the court needs to see now is only whether that leak was localized, was limited to those particular centers in Patna and Hazaribagh, or were they widespread to an extent that the court needs to order a retest. While we were expecting the court to conclude the hearing and pass an order by today, that has not really happened. The court has passed one direction though. Remember, there was one question which was disputed in the question paper, where grace marks were given to students where two answers were considered correct for one question. That issue has also been brought up before the court, where the court has also expressed in a way its disapproval towards the fact that NTA decided to consider two answers as the correct answer for one question. As of now, the court has also remarked that what is worrying the court as of now is that over 4 lakh students in fact, ended up getting the benefit of NTA's decision to consider two answers as the correct answer.
Well, we also have some more information coming in from that hearing in the Supreme Court. While Supreme Court asking IIT Delhi to form a 3-member panel to probe physics question with two answers, IIT D panel to submit a report by noon tomorrow. NEET hearing, the Supreme Court that resumes tomorrow. This is the latest that we have. Supreme Court has asked IIT Delhi in the meanwhile to form a 3-member panel. And the panel will be probing physics question with two answers. IIT D panel to submit a report by noon tomorrow. NEET hearing in the Supreme Court resumes tomorrow. Srishti is still with us. Srishti, please give us more. NEET hearing has been pushed to tomorrow. And in the meanwhile, we believe that IIT Delhi has been asked to form a 3-member panel to probe physics question with two answers. Could you elaborate exactly what this means?
Well, yes, Sabila, as per the live updates that my colleague Anu Sharda has just sent from inside the court has passed its direction with regard to question number 19 of the NEET UG exam. And in order to resolve the controversy surrounding that question, the court has now sought an expert opinion from IIT Delhi director. The director of IIT Delhi has been asked to constitute a team, an expert team of 3 experts of the subject concerned, to tell the court their opinion with regard to what the answer to that particular question should be. Now, the court had during the hearing also remarked that over 4 lakh students had benefited from NTA's decision to consider 2 answers as the correct answer to for this particular question. Amongst the top 61 students, 44 students out of those 61 students are those who received grace marks because 2 answers were correct, considered to be the correct answer for this one particular question. To clear that confusion and to in a way put an end to that controversy, the court has asked IIT Delhi, as I just told you, to constitute a 3-member committee to give its opinion and clear the confusion over that one particular question. Even the Registrar General has been requested to communicate the same order to IIT Delhi to ensure that the court, that their opinion is communicated to the court by tomorrow. Now, we also saw Solicitor General Tushar Mehta also tell court that he would be getting an answer to that particular aspect by tomorrow, but the court has decided to go ahead, constitute an expert, ask the IIT Delhi director to constitute an expert committee to get an expert opinion from the experts on the subject matter concerned to basically understand what answer should be considered as the correct answer. The court had remarked that over 4 lakh students were benefited due to the NTA's decision to consider 2 answers as the correct answer. Now, this is not the only aspect which we've seen being flagged by the petitioners before the Supreme Court. It initially started off with the aspect of paper leak at Hazaribagh in Patna, where we saw the top court clearly say that the fact that a paper leak did happen is very clear. Question papers were disseminated. We also saw the petitioners bring up the issue of the investigation which was done by the Bihar Police and the Bihar Economic Offences Unit. During the last hearing, the petitioners had told the court that center and NTA not portraying
एक जो क्वेश्चन फिजिक्स का क्वेश्चन है उसकी वजह से टॉप रैंक पे 400% की इन्फ्लेशन थी उसके बारे में भी डिस्कशन हुआ. सबको सुनने के बाद कोर्ट ने बोला है कि जो पिटिशनर्स को आज मौका नहीं मिल पाया है वो एक रिटन सिनॉप्सिस जो है आज शाम तक कोर्ट के आगे ईमेल के थ्रू कोर्ट को देंगे और बाकी जो है कल रिस्पोंडेंट्स भारत सरकार और एनटीए की जो है उनके आर्गुमेंट्स को सुना जाएगा और उसके बाद फाइनल डिसाइड होगा. Today, the petitioner has completed their arguments. Court has directed us to file the written synopsis who are not able to address the court in today's hearing. By evening, the other petitioners can file their written synopsis to the court through email. And thereafter, the court will, the matter has been adjourned for tomorrow for the arguments of the respondent, Union of India and NTA.
All right, so you have the counsel there speaking of the court's decision. For the moment, it's been pushed to tomorrow, the court hearing on NEET re-examination. Well, that said, you have the court directing for IIT Delhi to form a 3-member panel with this regard to probe physics question with 2 answers. The IIT D panel will be submitting a report by noon tomorrow. IIT Delhi has been asked, they've been put on the job, while NEET hearing will resume tomorrow noon. In fact, at this point, scores of students are currently awaiting for the decision on NEET, whether or not a re-examination will be announced by the Supreme Court. As anticipation grows, they're looking at the court deciding on the matter tomorrow, hopefully without further delay.